Hello friends, today I am going to discuss the topic single stub matching. Okay, so using a single stub, how we can match a load to a transmission line, that whole process I will be discussing in this lecture using Smith chart. Okay, so for the transmission line, impedance of the line is given as a Z0 and load impedance is given as a ZL. So impedance contains two values, one is RL, another can be plus or minus of jXL. RL given as a real value and XL denotes the imaginary value. So when this ZL and Z0 both are not equal, that condition is called as a mismatch condition. So to avoid this mismatch, we will use the Smith chart, okay, and we will insert a stub. Then we will try to bring Z0 closer to ZL. When ZL will be equal to Z0, that condition is called as a matched condition. So there are several methods which we can use to match the load from the transmission line. So basically, when we will define the types of the matching, depending upon the series and shunt, we can divide into two types. So first one will be called as a series single stub matching. When we are doing the series single stub matching, our Smith chart will act as a impedance chart. Second type is shunt single stub matching. When we are using the shunt single stub matching, then Smith chart will be called as a admittance chart or Y chart. Okay, so this we have to remember. For series single stub matching, Smith chart will behave as a impedance chart, and for shunt single stub matching, Smith chart will behave as a admittance chart. Okay, so series single stub matching using Smith chart is considered as a impedance chart, already I told, okay, and shunt single stub matching Smith chart is considered as a admittance chart. Further, series and shunt both are divided into two types depending upon the stub property, whether stub is open circuited or short circuited. So again, for series single stub matching, we are having two types: open circuit series single stub and short circuit series single stub. Okay, so to understand the series single stub matching, first we should know what is Smith chart. Okay, so as you can see here, a graphical representation. This type of graphical representation is called as a Smith chart. By using this, we can plot any possible value of impedance on the Smith chart and any possible value of reflection coefficient on the Smith chart. So as you can see here, this dotted line, okay, so from this point to this end, we can see an orange color dotted line. This divides Smith chart into two portion, upper half and lower half. Okay, upper half denotes the inductive region, as I have written here plus value. So if any possible positive values of reactance will be denoted on the upper side of the Smith chart, and the lower side will represent the negative values, means capacitive reactance on the lower half. Okay, and as you can see, the green color dotted line, this I have represented for unity circle. Okay, it's a important circle for the Smith chart. Okay, so when we'll see the Smith chart from this point, it represents the outer circle, represents the zero resistance circle. Okay, as we have seen, the impedance is divided into two portions, okay, real value and imaginary value. So real value, this outer circle represents the zero resistance circle. Okay, and one circle will be here at this point, which will be called as an infinity circle. So value of resistance we'll see, it is like 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 1 here. So for resistance R is equal to 1 circle, I have denoted as a dark green lines. Okay, then if we'll move on this side, the last value is infinite. So by knowing these R values, we can represent that what point will be having open circuit and what point we can call as short circuit. So we know that when resistance R is equal to 0, so this point denotes the short circuit value, okay, and this point is infinity, it means circuit is open, so this will be considered as a open circuit. Okay, so for we are taking one example. Okay, we are taking load value ZL as 100 plus j80 ohm. Okay, so real value R is 100, okay, and reactive value is j80 plus. So when we are, I told you, when it is plus, means the value will fall upper half of the Smith chart. Okay, characteristic impedance of the transmission line is given as a 50 ohm. So we cannot directly plot the impedance, load impedance value on the Smith chart. So first we have to normalize this value with respect to the characteristic impedance. Okay. So 100 divided by 50 is 2 and 80 divided by 50 is 1.6. So our normalized value is 2 plus 1.6J. Okay. Okay, so we got the normalized load impedance as 2 plus 1.6J. So our real value of the impedance is 2. So we have to find out circle of 2. Constant resistance circle will find out. Okay, so this circle is 1. If I'll move right hand side 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8 and 2. So this circle is representing R is equal to 2 value. Okay, and reactance value, as I told, is a positive. So that value will lie on the upper half side. So from here it is 0. Okay, and it moves like 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like this will move on and will reach out to infinity. So our value is 1.6. So we'll read out here. As you can see, orange lines are given to showcase the positive reactance values. So if you are reading here, it's 1.6. Okay, so this 1.6 reactance line and R is equal to 2 resistance line intersects at this point. So that will be represented as a load impedance ZL. Okay, please concentrate. The resistance value R is equal to 2 circle and the constant reactance circle 1.6J is this one. So when both are meeting at this point, so this point is representing your load impedance ZL. Okay. After this, what we'll do? We know the center point of the Smith chart. So using this center line, and we have plotted the ZL. Okay, using the scale, we will draw a straight line from center to the load impedance to the outer side of the Smith chart. So we'll draw a straight line from here, as you can see. So this line, then we'll read out the outer Smith chart value. Okay, here we have to remember one thing. We are moving from load to the generator. Okay, so on Smith chart, we can see WTG. This represents wavelength towards generator. So whenever we are plotting the value, we will move clockwise. Okay, so here we can see the intersecting point, outer side, we have to read the value. Okay, and the outer Smith chart, we have to read the values. Here we can read 0.2 and in between 0.21. Okay, so that value is approximately 0.208. So we'll write it here 0.208. These all values are with corresponding to the lambda. So we, what I told you, that first we have to plot the load impedance, then from the center to the load impedance we have to use the scale. Okay, and we have to extend this line. Wherever this line is giving me the intersection at the outer circle, we have to read out that value and we have to write it here. Okay, after this we have to take the radius from center to the load impedance. Okay, ZL, as you can see, from the center to load impedance, and then we'll draw a circle. Okay, so we have drawn a circle and we seen that this constant VSWR circle gives us an intersection with the unity circle at two points. As you can see here, this orange color line and this green color line. Okay, orange color line belongs to the constant VSWR circle, which we are drawing, taking as a radius from center to the load impedance. Okay, and same way we are getting one intersection at the upper half and one intersection at the lower half. So we got two values. I tell you as like D1 and D2. So first we plotted the ZL on the Smith chart, then we taken the radius from center to ZL and drawn a constant VSWR circle, and then we find two intersection with the unity circle, which I already drawn on the Smith chart. Okay, so these two values, now what we are doing is we have to always move towards the generator. As I told, we are moving from load to the generator, so we cannot go upper side, we have to move towards down. So when we are moving on this line and we are reaching at the intersection point, what it says is our real part of the load is matched to the real value of the characteristic impedance. Okay, so our real part is matched. Now whatever reactance part is available here, that we have to cancel out. So to match this real part, we have to find out the distance, how much distance we moved from load to the intersection. Okay, so for this again we'll use a scale, and from the center to this D2 point we'll extend a line towards outside the Smith chart. So we'll read out here a value. What is the value at the outer circle? So as we see, that value is in between 0.32 and 0.33. This value we can note down as a 0.328 lambda. Okay, so we got two values. At ZL, value is 0.208 lambda. Okay, forget the all the values we had to represent as a with lambda coefficient. Okay, 0.208 lambda, and this value is 0.328 lambda. So difference of these two values will give you what distance we have to move to insert the stub from the load. Okay, so we can find out. So now D, how we'll calculate? 0.328 lambda minus 0.208 lambda. So as you can see here, D is equal to 0.328 minus 0.208 lambda, means distance of the stub from the load is 0.120 lambda. So one thing we find it out. Okay, so as you can see here, we were having the load and the characteristic line of Z0 impedance. We are going to insert a stub to match the load with the Z0. So first task is to find the D, what is the distance where we are going to add the stub. So we calculated the distance of 0.120 lambda we are going to insert the stub. Now our next task is to find the length of the stub. What should be the length of the stub? So it is possible that we can design a short circuited stub, or we can design an open circuited stub. So we have taken our problem for open circuited stub. As you can see, this portion is open, so this is called as an open circuited stub. So what amount of reactance we have to add, that will decide the length of the stub. Okay, so now we are coming to the Smith chart. We reach to the D2 position. So when we are reaching to the D2 position, we are cancelling the real part, and our real part is matched. Okay, at ZL point my real part was 2. Okay, when we moved from this point to the unity circle, now real part is 1, so my real part is matched. So at this position D2, we will find out what is the value of reactance. So as you can see here, the green line shows the reactance values. Okay, 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, like that, 0 to infinity it shows. Okay, on Smith chart if you read from here, it starts from 0, okay, and slowly it increases and it goes till infinity. Okay, so at this D2 point, the value is in between 1.2 and 1.4. Okay, or we can say between 1.3 and 1.4. Okay, so that value will read out, that value is 1.33J in minus. Okay, so we will find out this value using the scale. Again, we can draw. What we have to do is we have to extend this line. Okay, in such a way so that we can find the exact value, and from the center to this we can draw a straight line. Okay, so this is our reactance part. So our task is how we can match the stub if we add a positive value of reactance for this value. Okay, it means if I add plus 1.33J, this reactive part will be 0 and I will move to the center and I will reach the match point on the Smith chart, which is the center point of the Smith chart. Okay, so our task is to start from ZL and reach out the unity circle. Okay, and then add the opposite value of the reactance so that we can cancel out the reactance offered here and we reach out the center point. So our value is minus 1.33J. So opposite value will be plus 1.33J. So this will be exactly at opposite side, means upper side, upper half of the Smith chart. So here we'll find out 1.33J, that will be somewhere near to this. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll extend this line from the center. So using the scale, from center to this value, and we'll extend this line like this, and we'll read out the value here for the reactive value, 1.33J, which is positive. So we have to add a stub which should offer us plus 1.33J reactance. Okay, and our condition is that our stub should be open circuited. Okay. So in a Smith chart, as I told in the beginning itself, that infinity point is open circuit. Okay. So length will be given from the open circuit to the point where we are getting the 1.33J. So when we'll start from here, this value correspond to 0.25. Okay. Again, I will explain you. Smith chart started from 0. Okay. 0 lambda, 0.125 lambda, and then 0.25 lambda, then 0.375 lambda, and 0.5 lambda. So when we are moving from open circuit to this length 1.33J. Okay. So we'll start from here. And why I am moving like this? Because wavelength towards generator. I cannot move in a positive direction. Okay. I have to move towards generator always. So I am moving like this. So I started from open circuit point and I am moving like this and I will reach out to 1.33J lambda. So at 1.33J reactance, we have to read out the outer circle value. Okay. So outer circle value is here corresponding to 0.148 lambda. As we can read here, see 0.14 and 0.15. I have to read outer circle value. It is equivalent to 0.148 lambda. Okay. So we started from 0.25. Okay. We will reach to the 0.5. Again, this value correspond to the 0. So I cannot directly minus from this to this. Okay. So I have to minus from 0.5 to 0.25. So as you can see, for finding out the length, I am using 0.5 minus 0.25 plus 0.14 lambda. Okay. So this 0.5 correspond to this value and 0.25 correspond to this value and 0.14 lambda correspond to this value. So we have to minus 0.5 minus 0.25 and we have to add this length. Okay. From the open circuit. So that is close to 0.398 lambda. Okay. So now we can see here, length of the stub is given as a 0.398 lambda. Okay. And distance is 0.120 lambda. So we found the length of the stub and distance from the load. Okay. Again, I'm going to just explain the basic process. Okay. From the initial point of view, how we'll do it. See, first load impedance is given. Okay. So we have to find out the load impedance and characteristic impedance of line is given. So do the normalization 100 by 50 and J80 by 50. We will get the normalized load value. Okay. Then using this normalized load value, we'll plot on the Smith chart. Then we'll take from the center to the load impedance, the radius, and we'll draw a constant VSWR circle. We'll see two intersecting points. Okay. And we have to remember that we cannot move towards load. We have to move always towards generator. So first intersecting point is this one. So we are taking D2 as an intersecting point. So when we are starting from ZL to this point, we match the real part. And again from D2 to the center, we match the reactance part. So this one is the difference between D2 and ZL, outer circle values. Okay. And then from here when we are starting, then we are taking as an open circuit. So from the open circuit, what is the length of the stub which will offer me positive 1.33J reactance. Thank you so much.